Hey there, gang. I wanted to talk to you about the situation in Sydney at the moment with the musical Hedwig and the Angry Inch, and kind of talk more broadly about representation in media. Now, for those not up with the situation, Hedwig and the Angry Inch is a 1998 rock musical. And the initial premise of the musical is that Hedwig is a feminine gay man from East Germany who is coerced into medically transitioning by their American lover so that they can marry and escape East Berlin. She comes to America, the Berlin Wall comes down, she's dumped, works with another artist, he rips her off and becomes famous, and she is left eking out a life playing in bars in middle America. It's definitely not a perfect work, and the way you know it deals with trans topics is a bit probo. Nevertheless, it has some fucking bops, some really great tunes. And personally, as a trans rock singer and comedian, it is up there as one of my dream roles. Yeah, I sang The Origin of Love at the launch of Sydney Mardi Gras 2 years ago, maybe 3 years ago. But I definitely brought a whole bunch of people to tears. Not one to brag, but, you know, a lot of mascara streaming down faces. Anyway, you know, I had originally seen Hedwig performed by IOTA many years ago, probably almost a decade ago, and it was very significant personally in helping me come to understand my own relationship with gender. Now, Sydney Festival were planning on mounting a production of Hedwig at the start of next year with a cisgender actor in the title role. And after they announced the season, queer activists penned an open letter and petition criticising the casting, and the producers subsequently cancelled the production with this statement. And I don't know exactly what they mean by no one was excluded, because as Australia's premier trans rock comedian, I wasn't asked to audition. I guess I wasn't excluded, I just wasn't included. Now, a lot of the commentary around this has been about the actor who was cast, and I'm not going to focus on him because obviously I don't think that's fair or really relevant, right? But look, the day after they cancelled the production, my inbox lit up with a bunch of reporters and radio shows and news programs wanting my comment on this situation, which isn't new. I am usually the person who gets a ring to be a talking head on trans stuff. But I didn't want to comment on this on the telly or radio for two reasons. One, if they do decide to recast with a trans performer, then I reckon I probably got a shot. And two, I didn't want to comment on a platform that I didn't control, because this is a topic that is complicated and nuanced, and I didn't want my measured and thoughtful analysis reduced to an inflammatory soundbite. A lot of the commentary now, today, in the last couple of days, is focusing on whether the character even is trans and whether a trans actor is needed or not, and whether a good actor should be able to play any role and blah, 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 blah. So here we go. Look, I believe that any actor should have the opportunity to play any role. I do. That would be a utopia. But we don't live in a world where that is the case. We live in a world where the majority of acting and performing opportunities are offered to people who are cisgender white men, right? And not just acting and performing, directing, everything. And there are countless studies that I can link below that show that the world we see in media is less diverse than the world that actually exists. And I think you would find it very difficult to argue against that. And transgender performers have very few opportunities to perform or contribute meaningfully in telling transgender stories. There is an assumption that if you have a trans person in your story, then their transness needs to be justified or rationalized in some way, even in minor or inconsequential roles. Trans people aren't neutral enough to play minor roles, so quite often trans people don't get cast in minor roles. And when it comes to major roles, where the character is trans, well, those roles have been given to cis people too, because there aren't enough trans people with experience or clout or whatever rationalization. And it's a cyclical systemic problem, right? It's baked into the system and it constantly reinforces itself. And to break that cycle, we actually need to make meaningful and thoughtful changes. And the very first step in moving towards a world where there is opportunity for everyone to play anything, we need to make sure that people at least have the opportunities to play themselves. And I say this as a transgender actor who is experienced. Prior to transition, I made a comfortable living from acting and voiceover work. You know, I would go to 3 or 4 auditions a week and I would get bookings pretty much every month. Now I have 1 or 2 opportunities a year. I definitely make the most of those opportunities. I'm fortunate to have them. And I have seen changes in the last couple of years. I even got to play some minor roles this year. See, the problem isn't so much that trans people aren't being cast for trans roles. The problem is trans people aren't being cast for anything. Not even trans roles. Not even when they have experience. And I'm not really having a dig at the producers or anyone, because the problem, as I said, is with the system, not with particular people. I'm not trying to label people transphobic or pointing fingers or whatever. I'm asking for all of us to look at the systems that influence the world we live in, question whether they're fair or not, and whether we have the power to change them.
Oh, but shouldn't it go to the person who is best for the job?
Yes, absolutely. This is a show about gender, about physical transition, about surgery, about becoming disenfranchised with the music industry, missing out on opportunities you deserve and are entitled to, or having your life fall to pieces and picking yourself back up again after transitioning. And you should cast someone who has lived experience in all those things. Because that's interesting. And maybe it explores the role in a way that it hasn't been before when it's been performed by a cisgender performer. And look, because this video is probably just as much an audition tape as it is a commentary on diversity in media, here's Wig in a Box from Hedwig and the Angry Inch.
On nights like this, when the world's a bit amiss, and the lights go down across the trailer park, I get down, I feel high, I feel on the verge of going mad. And then it's time to punch the clock. I put on some makeup and turn on the tape deck and put the wig down on my head. Suddenly I'm Miss Midwest, midnight checkout queen, until I head home and I put myself to bed. I look back on where I'm from, look at the woman I've become, and the strangest things seem suddenly routine. I look up from my vermouth on the rocks, a gift wrapped wig still in the box of towering velveteen. I put on some makeup, some love and become, and pull the wig down from the shelf. Suddenly I'm Miss Beehive 1963, until I wake up and I turn back to myself. Some girls, they got a natural ease. They wear it any way they please, with their French flip curls and perfumed magazines. Wear it up, let it down. This is the best way that I've found to be the best you've ever seen. I put on some makeup, turn on the 8-track. I'm pulling the wig down from the shelf. Suddenly I'm Fawcett from TV, until I wake up and I turn back to myself. Stag by level 5, Darby Hamilton. Sausage girl, she can waste it all because of you. With your blow-dried feather back, Tony Homewood too. Flip, blow, frizz, flop, it's all because of you. It's all because of you, all because of you.
All right, everybody. I put on some makeup, turn on the 8-track. I'm pulling the wig down from the shelf. Suddenly I'm this punk rock star of stage and screen, and I never